Hey guys, Mohan Pobar here, and today we're going to talk about how to set goals and actually achieve them. Let's get to it. So how do you set goals and actually finally achieve them? I'm sure you know about all those people who go to the gym 1st of January, and then 2 weeks goes by and you don't see them again. And I know people who set goals again and again, but they never achieve them. I know people who have different methods for achieving goals. Some people tell you just set realistic goals. Some people will tell you to set goals you can never achieve in your lifetime. There's so many different methods to achieve your goals, and you just don't know what to follow. You can get overwhelmed. This person tell you that, that person tell you that. This guy tell you to write your affirmations one time a day. This guy tell you to write the affirmations 2 times a day. This guy tells you to write your affirmation 50 times a day. What do you do? What should you need to focus on? So many options out there. And unless you know where to focus your focus, you can just find yourself not knowing what to do, not knowing what goals to set, and not knowing how to actually achieve them. Because it's not about just setting goals and writing them down. Unless you're taking action towards those goals, there's no way you will achieve those goals. And I don't care how many times you write them a day or how much you'll feel your goal as if you live it already. Unless you're taking some kind of action and executing towards those goals, you have a very small chance of winning those goals, unless your goal is like winning the lottery. And then your only action should be to fill the lottery ticket, right? So what should you do? What are your best steps? So to begin with, I believe that the best goals, so I have a vision of where I see myself 10, 20, 30 years from now. But to be honest, I'm not even writing them down at this point because I can never know what will happen to me in a few years. Like what I found out is when I have a goal for 10 or 20 years from now, that's gonna change. And I think more than like a year from now, in my opinion, it's too much because you can't really your mind can't really accept that it's even possible, and it's going to look something completely out of the trajectory, out of your comfort zone, and you're going to get too overwhelmed that you won't know what to do next. Especially in the space of buying businesses that I'm talking about in my challenge, people writing goals, I want to become a billionaire and buy 20,000 businesses and blah blah, and all those different huge goals, which are cool to have, but then at the same time, your mind can't really accept that as a reality, so there's no way that you're actually going to execute towards that goal. There's just no fucking way. I need to stop saying that word because I heard it's working against my channel. But anyway, what I'm trying to tell you guys is that, in my opinion, you got to set a goal for, let's say, a year from now. Really have a goal where you can, yes, it can be outside your comfort zone a little bit, which I think is very important. Otherwise, if you're just going to set a goal that you already know is easier for you, I mean, why would you even set that goal, right? I think it's important to have a goal that is a bit outside your comfort zone. And I think you should set a goal where your mind can literally, sense that it's possible to achieve that goal. And when you feel it, you can actually think to yourself, yeah, that's possible. I can see myself having that goal. But then you understand that there are actions you should take towards that goal. And those actions are going to be sometimes outside of your comfort zone, and actions that are not going to be comfortable a lot of the time. And you need to accept that. So when you set, let's say, a yearly goal, you also want to set some kind of goals every 30 or 60 days until that goal. So let's say you have a yearly goal to do X. You want to have a goal for, let's say, 30, 60, 90 days, etc. That every 30, 60, 90 days, there's another milestone to achieve where you know that every goal that you achieve, that will get you towards that 1 year goal. Now, after you have that, you gotta start asking yourself, what are the actions that you gotta take daily in order to achieve those goals? And for me, I think it's also important to ask yourself, who do I need to become, or who do I need to be in order to be a person that is already living that goal? And that's gonna work on your mindset. I think just by asking that question, that's gonna literally change something in your mind to put you in a different life, even if it makes sense, because your mind is going to think completely different about things. Like, even ask yourself right now, just tell yourself how it feels to ask yourself, who do I need to be to own a $10 million business? For example, ask yourself, who do I need to be? What kind of actions do I need to take? What kind of habits do I need to have? What kind of beliefs do I need to have? Like, literally ask those questions to yourself, and you'll see your mind is the way you feel like it's changing, because you're going to look at life differently. And when you have that good fundamentals inside, that's where you can go and take those actions. And you every day got to ask yourself, What is the one most important thing I can take today in order to achieve my goal? And it's got to be about very simple things you're doing daily. I don't believe in the hustling 24/7 and working 24/7 a day. I don't believe people can work that much effectively. I believe you can achieve more in 1 hour of effective focused work than most people achieved in a week, literally, because people are just, they're drinking like 8 glasses of coffee and they're like all over the place and they're not really accomplishing everything. They feel like they're doing stuff. They lie to themselves that they're doing stuff. They feel productive, but they're not really productive. They're not really moving things forward. But instead, if you just had one or two or maximum 3 things to accomplish that are like legit important things to do daily, and you accomplish them and you do them first thing in the morning every day moving on for the next year, I promise you, your life is going to be different. Your life is going to be different because your actions are going to be different. Your mindset is going to be different. And then your results are going to be different. It's going to happen. But you got to constantly remind yourself and believe that it's possible. And literally block noises around you that tells you that it's not possible, that tells you that what you're doing isn't working. Because what most people are doing, that even if they follow those things that I just mentioned, they're starting to take action, but then they're stopping. And consistency is probably one of the most important things. If you, again, in the space of buying businesses, if you go out there and you work 1 day or you work 2 days and you do the best work possible, you go and talk to business owners and you originate deals and you make offers on businesses, but then after 3, 4, even 2 weeks, you just stop. You decide, you know what? I've done everything. I'm good now. I stopped. Or maybe you're not even aware of that, but you just stop the work because you have noises around you. You're too busy with your other stuff and you just stop that work. You can expect to get those results. Guys, we're talking about buying multi-million dollar businesses. You got to take those actions again, consistently, again and again and again in order to achieve those results. And only when you do that, you can actually achieve your goals. So you got to have some kind of accountability, in my opinion, and support to make sure that you're taking those actions. Like, write yourself down, what kind of actions do I need to take today? And in the end of the day, like literally look at your day, look back at your day and ask yourself, did I achieve that goal? Did I achieve that outcome? Did I take that action? And if you didn't, you got to have some kind of a punishment option where you got to do something against your will or comfort zone. Like go and burn a note of $100 because you didn't take an action today. And trust me, you're going to burn $100 every day for different actions you didn't take. You'll eventually do that work. And I don't care how much money you have or burn more money if you feel like $100 is enough for you. But eventually, you'll get to a point where like, I'm not going to burn this fucking money. I'm not going to burn that money. I'm going to work. I'm going to do the work that I said that I will do. And eventually, your life is going to be different. So those are my thoughts. I think that it's very important to have goals, but then it's about the things around your goals that are even more important. It's about the attitude that you have in your mindset and beliefs. It's about the actions that you're taking. And it's about the support and accountability to make sure that you're consistently taking those actions. So yeah, that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Subscribe to the channel if you didn't yet. It really helps me. Comment below, like the video. And if you want to explore working with me and my team to buy your first business or grow your existing business by acquisitions, by buying other companies, which I believe is much better than growing organically one client at a time, then go to juanpobera.com/quiz. That's it. I hope you enjoyed it and I'll see you soon.